stuff that he's doing is nothing less than sensational. So the stage is yours.
Hello everyone, my name is Felix. I come from Hong Kong. Hong Kong people love food. So wine, pizza, steak, we eat everything that you guys love to eat too. For drinks, Hong Kong people prefer soy milk. We drink it more than milk. But as you may know, soy milk is a perishable. But today we can enjoy soy milk every day. We can buy anywhere without worrying about it being spoiled because we have one person to thank. The clicker. This one. Reuben Rousing. This is a soy milk bought from Hong Kong. And I think everyone knows Tetra Pak. So Reuben Rousing, when he first discovered aseptic packaging in 1943, he probably didn't realize that he would create arguably one of the most successful food packaging invention in the world, and also create an industry that's worth 44 billion euros. So nowadays, you can have aseptic packaging for milk, juice, ice cream mixtures, even for wine, everything liquid. But there is no aseptic packaging for solid food, such as a piece of meat. So the technology was invented in 1943. 70 years later, an aseptic packaging for solid food was born in Hong Kong. And this is Elton. I met Elton at the Hong Kong Baptist University in 2013. We were there studying a Master's of Science in Food Analysis and Food Safety Management. Actually, when I was studying there, I already received my PhD from the University of Sydney in Plasma Physics. I've worked at Nature Publishing Group, a prestigious publisher in scientific journals, for 7 years. When we were at Hong Kong Baptist University, we were studying a project on the microbial risk of sous-vide food, but not any ordinary food. We were studying edible bird nests, the saliva produced by the swallow birds. It's a luxurious food that the Chinese love. We didn't know that we were studying the best specimen you can ever find, because edible bird nests, it comes from the soil, from the bird, so it got all kinds of bacteria that you can think of. Staphylococcus aureus, which is the soil bacteria, E. coli, which comes from the a gut bacteria, and also salmonella, which has the avian origin. And during our project, we learned how to control the microbials, like bacteria, fungi, at 60 to 80 degrees. So sous-vide, it's a very trendy technology at the moment that a lot of the chefs use to cook beef. The great thing about it is it's very well temperature controlled, and you can cook a piece of steak at a set temperature, and you can make perfect steak, medium rare, very juicy. But the thing is, with the current sous-vide technology, you can't create a shelf-stable food. So that's why we have developed a new technology called Advanced Sous-Vide Aseptic Packaging, or otherwise known as ASAP. And we have never shown our product in any events except for this one, because we decided to show our technology in Sweden, because this is the birth country of the aseptic packaging. And today I brought other food as well. On the slide, you can see that that's a piece of pork chops that has been processed in at 60 to 80 degrees. There are special features of these products. Number one, they're shelf stable. So this piece of steak or pork chop can be stored at room temperature, just like canned food, for up to 2 years. The other thing is, when you cook it, it's actually very juicy inside. It's actually medium rare. And if you look in the picture, there's actually some juice at the bottom, which is actually the myoglobin of the pork chop itself. A myoglobin, most people call it blood, but it's actually not blood. It's a protein that mammals use in order to do exercise, store oxygen, to do anaerobic exercise. And for the last 2 years, Elton and I have started a pilot factory in Hong Kong And we've been refining our processes. We've applied our patents in Hong Kong, China, Europe, and also the US. And also we've been trying to improve the reliability of this technology. So how does ASAP actually sterilize food at 60 to 80 degrees? As people working in the food industry should know, one of the most scary bacteria that will ruin food, make it toxic, is Clostridium botulinum, which requires heating temperature at around 121 degrees for at least 15 minutes. But the thing is, if you heat food for such a high temperature and for such a long time, the food will taste dry and also tough. So our technology, it's actually, we realized that, you know, people have been doing the wrong thing for the last 250 years. We put the whole food into a retort oven and heat everything at 121 degrees in order to try to sterilize the food. What we've discovered is for most packaged food, you have a container. You also have a solid food components, for example, a piece of salmon or a steak, and also a liquid food component such as oil, brine, or sauce. So for the sauce, you can use traditional retort method and heat up the sauce to sterilize it at 121 degrees for 15 minutes. They don't mind being heated for such a long time. But for the meat, I think most people don't know, meat is actually sterile on the interior. All the bacteria exist on the outside of the meat. So we've actually developed a technology that performs the surface sterilization, much like UHT, that heats the outside of the food at 160 degrees to flash sterilize the meat. And then if you sterilize the sauce, you sterilize the meat, and then you combine it, package it in an aseptic container, which is a sterile container, then the food itself will remain shelf stable, just like canned food. And the sous-vide part, what that does is it actually stabilizes the enzyme of the food so that the food won't break down and also will remain shelf stable. So with this technology, it's going to bring a lot of impact to the world. This is a piece of pork chop that after you take it out from a package, in theory, you can eat it straight from the bag. But for the best taste performance, we'll recommend that you grill it on the outside, either doing pan grill or oven, or you can just chop it up to do fried rice or stir fry, whatever you would like. This is a piece of roast beef that has been stored at room temperature for 3 months. Elton and I tried this the first time. We made sure that we had a good trip in China first before we tried the beef, so that, you know, in case something happens, at least you won't regret it. And this is juicy. It's, as you can see, it's medium rare. And the impact it's going to bring to the world is going to be huge. We are going to get rid of cold chain storage, cold chain logistics. I think you hear a lot in the talks about how to save the environment by not delivering food to very far places. That's only if you don't have the technology to protect your food. With this technology, you don't need much energy to actually make the food shelf stable. And also you don't much need cold chain technology. You don't need freezers to actually store the food and keep it edible. And also cooking a piece of steak from room temperature would only require seconds. This will be a lot faster than cooking a piece of beef stored in a piece of freezer. So we've done chicken, we've done beef, we've done pork, we've done scallops. Fish is a bit more tricky, but we've done it. And it's not just meat in olive oil. We've done barbecue sauce, curry, cream sauce, tomato sauce, all kinds of sauce. So the application is going to be huge. And we hope that this technology is going to make a change to the world. But we can't do this alone. We need the help of aseptic packaging equipment suppliers, the food processing equipment suppliers to help us, and also food manufacturers to help us. This is a very sophisticated technology. So I hope that with this introduction, we'll begin a food revolution from Hong Kong. Thank you very much.
That was great. Thank you so much. Thank you so much.